Welcome back to News Channel 5 at 6. A dramatic account tonight of the insidious grip methamphetamine holds on an addict. We've told you how the drug is made and why it's so dangerous. What's more, local law enforcement only expects the problem to get worse. Tonight, a recovering meth addict shares the story of his torment with News Channel 5's Bridget Shanahan. Bridget?
Well, George, meth is made solely from an explosive concoction of household chemicals. Even its residue can be harmful to children and adults. So just imagine what it can do when it's intentionally inhaled or injected. As one recovering addict tells us, he lost his friends, his job, and his mind.
It's the type of drug that will take things over.
And it's the kind of drug that can ruin lives, as this recovering meth addict tells us. We'll call him John for this story. He asked us to conceal his identity, not because he's ashamed of what he's done and where he's been, but because he doesn't want to put his family through any more pain.
It's almost like a blackout. So I remember bits and pieces, but for them it's the hardest because they're the ones who are, you know, in their right mind and watching the whole thing, hoping that I'll come back in some way.
John's from a small farm town in Vermont, but didn't try meth until he moved to the Midwest several years ago.
I don't know that I was necessarily like addicted the first time, but I know that I liked it and it felt good.
That made the second time easy, and the third time even easier. Eventually, snorting it wasn't good enough, so he started shooting it up, going on benders at clubs and raves, not sleeping for several days on end. And then, the delusion set in.
When I started really going crazy and I was, you know, losing it completely, I thought that, like, everybody was watching me. I thought there was cameras and everything. I thought the government was after me.
He lost his job, his friends, and his grasp on reality.
I don't even really remember what happened. I just know that I called the police, I called the hospital, and was frantic about something. And, you know, obviously I was just to the point of complete psychosis, and they came and they took me away and put me in a psych ward for a month.
Just bizarre thoughts that that don't bear any relationship to reality.
It's that psychotic state that Bill Young says is typical to all meth addicts. He's the executive director at Maple Leaf Farm, a substance abuse treatment center in Underhill.
The most important thing is that the public, and particularly our young folks, understand how dangerous it is.
Those at Maple Leaf Farm say the number of meth addicts they've treated over the years has remained fairly steady, and they're hoping it stays that way. They say that's because meth, in some ways, is more dangerous than other drugs because of how quickly it can deteriorate you, both mentally and physically.
When you understand how dangerous it is in so many ways, it makes you wonder, why would anybody even get involved? You know, not only in using it, but in making it.
But for every user, there is treatment, and John finally got his. He moved home to Vermont, got clean, and repaired his bond with his family. And he's sharing his story so no one has to go through what he did.
I can't believe how easy it is to access and, you know, to get and do here. You know, outside of Vermont is this quaint little place.
John's recovery process was intense. To overcome his psychological problems, he was put on multiple medications and says it took 8 months to fully recover. He's been clean now for 8 years. Bridget Shanahan, News Channel 5.